So, in the previous session, we started off seeing that how the illness is overcome. So previously we were discussing, our Vasishtha Maharishi was teaching us as to how the various adhis and vyadhis manifest. Now the question of overcoming it, it's not merely knowing about how they manifest, that will not end. It is not complete unless we know how to overcome it also. So what about the procedure of healing of adhis and vyadhis? We'll see. Vasishtha himself takes the initiative to respond. Then he says, before that he classifies adhis and vyadhis, sorry, into two. One is the sara and samaha. Saraha is those that are very strong. Sara means strong. Sarama means which doesn't go easily. We cannot wish it away. If you just sometimes you might have observed that you will have some stomachache or some headache or something like that. Something, ignore it and focus on the work, it will go away. You can just visualize certain things without even just ignore it. You feel as if it doesn't exist, it will go away. Sometimes, because you focus on the work, it will go away. But the sara is not like that. It has very strong and it will make its impact. You cannot just wish it away. We do that, it is our own, we are digging our own problem. So, hence, the problem. So, two types. Samanya, normal ones, which sometimes we can ignore, or by normal general transactions, activities, we can manage. Sara are those which are janmamaya, which will continue. They are life companions for us. So, two types, that classification was given. See, to deal also, you should have a classification. Only then you can manage for, you can see that approach in Yoga Sutra also. See, you can see that what is yoga according to Yoga Sutra? The Chitta Vritti Nirodha. After the Chitta Vritti Nirodha, you get that Vrittaya Panchakaya. Immediately, the methods of Chitta Vritti Nirodha does not come. Where does it, the method of Chitta Vritti Nirodha, where does it come? Sutra number 12. Abhyasa Vairagya. See, Chitta Vritti Nirodha has to be done. That statement is made. Immediately after that, what is stated is five types of vrittis. And then you get the method of overcoming abhyasa vairagya. So, in that, the commentary portion mentions that unless you know how many types are there, you cannot strategize on how to manage them. You can, because endless are the number of vrittis, because every moment, every second, so many vrittis, one by one, and they cloud our mind. So, once you think of how do I manage all these vrittis? So don't worry, let us first classify the vrittis. Then understand their nature, of which are to be prioritized, which can be managed later, that clarity will come. And then you can speak about the method. So that is the same approach, the template of approach, the method of approaching a problem. This again gives a beautiful template. So if problem is there, try to understand the varieties, the levels or the layers of it, and then you can prioritize which one to address first, which one to address later. So you can derive such methodological inputs also. This is again connected to healing. So when someone is sitting before you, try to understand whether it is a sara or saman. So in this way, that teaching is also given. So adhikshetra, that has parallels in Yoga Sutra also. Maybe in Ayurveda also you might have the same kind of approach. So pratena adhimateneva rashyanti vyavaharikaha adhikshetena adhikavaha shiyante vyadhayogya agam. Means how to overcome the samanya illness. First sara and samanya was classified. Immediately samanya is addressed. How to overcome the samanya? Whatever is the requirement, if that is given, that samanya illness will be good gone. As I gave the example, because of not taking the lunch, someone had a headache. Just provide just the lunch, add the bathroom. The stomach is full, then slowly that will also, the headache and other things will come. So, praptena abhimatena. Abhimata means whatever is a desire, if that is given, then certain things will subside, both at the level of the body and at the level of mind. So, the व्यावहारिक ट्रांसैक्शनल सामान्य व्याधि स्थिति मैनेज सो व्हिच आर हैज एन अधि सामान्य इलनेस सो सामान्य अधि विल बी ओवरकम बाय गिविंग अभिमत सामान्य व्हाट एवर इज द अभिमत एट द सामान्य लेवल इफ यू गिव इट अधि क्षयेन अधि भावः एंड देन व्याधयः अपि अलग सो सामान्य adhi is overcome by giving whatever is required for the mind samanya vyadhi is overcome is giving whatever is required for the body so two methods two approaches are given now we go is this clear alam is also used the word alam what is alam here the commentator says completely this means all samanya adhis are completely overcome if you assess the requirement and give it to the mind all samanya vyadhis are completely overcome without exception if it is samanya can be addressed just by understanding the requirement of the body and giving it so that alam does not mean enough there are many words many meanings to the word alam so alam samasthyena samagriyena that's the meaning For every doctor, this might be a question. That's how we just would be overcome. Completely, we will be overcome. Yes. Samanya vyadhis alam means can be completely overcome by giving the appropriate things under the body and the mind.
Sir, in Ayurveda, we have a sutra for this. Samanena samanasya vritti. Viparitena viparitasya rasa. This is what is the sutra, which is...
Probably is manifest in the form of this teaching.
Yes, in dhatu kshaya. Dhatu vartaka.
That's all.
If rakta kshaya is there, you give rakta. Implicit. That is samanya.
Samanya. So samanya approach and completely is the assurance. Yes. Completely is the assurance that the shastra gives.
Okay.
But this also comes with experience. So this again does come easily by doing, by practicing, by learning under the teacher and observing. So this comes. Now, sara. Sara vyadhi. Means janmamaya, which is going to continue. Which will not be visual, which will not go away. How to manage those? It can only be managed. So how to manage that? So that is given here. But this our shastra says it can also be rooted out. That sara vyadhi can also be rooted out. That you will see. Atma jnanam vina saro. Let us not be in sorrow. Atma jnanam vina saraha. We'll do it that way. Atma jnanam vina saraha.
Atma jnanam vina saraha.
What's it?
Atma jnanam vina saraha.
Nathir nashyati rakhava.
Nathir nashyati rakhava. Nathir nashyati rakhava.
no sorrow. Because only when Purusha Prakriti joining is there, dukkha. Purusha Prakriti are separate, no dukkha. So, join sorrow. Bhuyo rajva bodhena ranju sarko.
Therapy settings and also from a spiritual perspective.
from the absolute spiritual perspective, until and unless you realize that you are not the body, you are not the mind, you are not the senses, you are not the objects that you associate yourself with, you are pure consciousness, Sachidananda Swarupa, that is Atma Jnanam. Without that Atma Jnanam, deep-rooted psychological problems are not overcome. That is from a spiritual perspective. And Atma Jnanam in the therapy settings, I'm just loud thinking only, Atma Jnanam in the therapy settings is bringing the care seeker to a realistic assessment of the self, of that person. A person cannot stay in imaginary inflated notions about oneself. A therapist should work in such a way that he brings the care seeker to the realistic circumstances, situations and the nature of the person who is seeking. So that is also Atma Jnana. What is your body? What is your conditions around? What are the kinds of relationships you are going through? What are all your fears, phobias? Why they have come about? Slowly, if not in one session, in multiple sessions, together with the working with the patient, slowly discovering the self of the patient should be done with the by the therapist. Only when the uncovering of the real nature or the real assessment of the patient is done, such potent psychological problems can be overcome. This is from a psychological therapy perspective. It is not that just like for a headache you swallow this pill, this will go away. It doesn't happen that way. Deep-rooted psychological problems are to be overcome by assisted self-discovery of the patient. So that is the psychological insight that we may derive. But the spiritual input is always there. From our Shastra perspective, until you realize that your consciousness, all that is associated with the body and the mind, etc., that we associate, and then we fall in our own creations, the web of connections that we create, notional web that we create, and then fall into so many psychological traps and illnesses. Separate yourself, you are Shuddha Chaitanya Sachidananda. So hence, deep-rooted adhis can be overcome by Atma Jnanam. And that Atma Jnanam has two possible interpretations that we can think of. And then, this is just beautiful. The example he gives, Atma Jnanam. How is that Atma Jnanam? Bhuyaha. And this is not an activity of one time. It is bhuyaha. Bhuyaha means bhuyasa loka parishinana. Bhuyasa loka parishinana. Seeing many instances around, illustrations around, examples around. Oh, these are, I am unable to give appropriate examples in the psychological setting. Maybe we can think. So one has to do so many case studies. A teacher, a therapist should have bhuyaha, means he should cite so many such examples in the self-discovery of the particular patient who is seeking that remedy. Bhuyaha means so many examples are to be given that you are not this, you are not this, you are not this, you are not this, this is your real nature. So, but one singular point that comes through is psychological problems are not overcome by just one effort. It is bhuyaha, it is a practice. Because we have internalized certain patterns of thinkings, to undo those patterns of thinkings, you have to establish alternative patterns. Klishta. See, these klishta vrittis you have practiced. Whenever someone nicks the brow, immediately you have gained that impression that this person is not happy with me. So immediately I will modify my responses, and then I will forget what I have to tell. I will modify my response and accordingly I will respond. So in this way, so many kleshas we have incorporated, so many klishta patterns we have incorporated. point that essentially yoga shastra is a binary shastra. Only two, vrittis and samskaras. Nothing is there beyond in yoga shastra. You may hear of the five kleshas, you may hear of the prakriti purusha, you may hear of ashtanga yoga, kriya yoga, samadhi, all multiple things are there, but finally it is only vritti and samskara. So you may see a beautiful building, but it is essentially brick and cement. In that same computer also, you see wonderful programs, but finally it is on or off. That is binary, zero or one, that's it. Similarly, the entire yoga shastra is a binary of vrittis and samskaras. Unfavorable samskaras lead to unfavorable vrittis and their manifestation in the form of adhivya. Favorable samskaras slowly have to replace it and then slowly manifest the beneficial act. So you decode every other practice, all the kleshas are nothing but the samskaras. Kleshas are all vasanas. And Ashtanga Yoga, Yama Niyama, Asana are all vrittis which will create favorable vasanas in the mind. You keep doing the asana, keep your samamkaya shirogri, you keep practicing, keep practicing, keep practicing. Whenever you sleep, you will always be samamkaya shirogri, that is the samskara. So in this way, all this is vrittis and samskaras, and you can manipulate the vrittis and samskaras only by the bhuya. Bhuya is the word. Yes.
Here the word bhuya has anything to do with the word bhavati, should happen or will happen?
No, it is a avyaya, just entirely avyaya, which means repeated again and again. So that which is done by repetition. So, this the point here is, Atma Jnanam does not come about by one Upanishad. Atma Jnanam, in two levels that we discussed, that cannot happen by one setting. One Upanishad of Ramana Maharshi does not get us anywhere. We repeatedly read, we repeatedly listen to lectures, but it doesn't happen. And similarly, one sitting with a psychologist also does not make any difference. It has to be Bhuya. In different sessions, different approaches, different strategies are to be planned by a psychologist. Loka Parikshan, he has to examine what are all the appropriate examples that I can give to this person to come to the realities, come into terms with the realities of his self. So that is Loka Parikshana, and it has to be done not only by the therapist. In that, the participant or the patient should also be in that bhuya activity. In yoga, the basic factor of failure of yoga techniques is motivation. Motivation to practice this bhuya. All the techniques are fine. You see in the research studies, you will see they are not motivated enough to do it daily. And that is a major factor of the less impact in the outcomes that we expect. So this bhuya is important. And Rajju Avabodhena, Rajju Avabodhena, Rajju Sarvahahi Nashyat. Rajju means rope. Rajju means a rope. Rajju Avabodha, understanding that this is a rope. Rajju Sarvaha, I will explain the flow of this thing. Rajju Sarvaha, the snake that is appearing on the rope. The snake that is appearing on the rope is called as Rajju Sarpa. Means the light is not there. There is only a twilight coming. Something which is in a twirled way is lying there. I start, that is merely a Rajju, that is merely a rope, but I superimpose a Sarpa there. Then that is called as Rajju Sarpa. There is nothing called as a Rajju Sarpa. Rajju Sarpa is our own creation. But someone by my side says, see, in this area there are no snakes. I know this area well. It will not, I don't know, really. There are many. But I am just citing for this example. right next to you, a person who knows this particular terrain says, oh, that is merely a road. Yesterday I only put it there. I didn't wind it up properly. It doesn't happen very once or twice or thrice. Many times, many people have to come and say, one has to switch on the light. So, by many ways, many approaches, see that Rajju Sarpa is managed easily. But this Rajju Sarpa means we have superimposed the Sarpa on ourselves, whereas we are only a Rajju. So, that kind of misperceptions or miscontent, see, that is something which can be objectified. Objectified and external circumstances can bring a better understanding about it. This is about our own self. This is the most difficult part. Dashamas Tomasi, have you heard? I hope you have heard this story. Dashamas Tomasi, you are the 10th person. It's a famous story of self-discovery. 10 students of a guru, they cross a river. The guru has already informed them that always hold your hands, ensure that you are 10 people, you go 10 and come back as 10. So always 9 people are made to stand and the 10th person is counting, so the counting comes only to 9. Only the onlooker, he says, you are the 10th person. So no one is missing, there is not a human crying that the 10th person is gone, missing in the river. Then some onlooker comes and says, you also stand in the line, let me count. So that self-discovery, self-understanding about that means each of them will come and count. Still 9 only will be there, they don't understand that they are the missing person. Swami Dayananda Saraswati of Harshavidya Rupa, he has written a book, you are the problem, you are the solution. If you find the book, you can please read. Harshavidya publication is there. The problem here is the Rajju we are, but we perceive ourselves as Sarpa, and then there is not a problem. So the point is, Bhuyaha is the key. By looking at various instances, if that person himself does not understand, a therapist or a person who is in the path of giving the healing should use that Bhuyaha, use various techniques to bring about the knowledge of the self. See, today I saw a newspaper open front page in the Indian Express. There is a news where it says the AIIMS Delhi is going to start a spiritual healing department in Delhi. So this gives a kind of a hint towards that. This shloka forms the basis. That is, the sara adhi psychological problem can be overcome by atma. But you have to read that report. I have the image. I can post that. The way it is written, the article, the news report appears is AIIMS is going to start, but no one knows how it will work. And then it is also non-scientific. Already they have passed the judgment that it is non-scientific, and then not a section of the AIIMS faculty are not happy with it. All that they have seen. How can you say non-scientific without subjecting it to scientific evaluation? Can you say it right away? Is it scientific on your part? So I was reflecting upon it. The same Indian Express, there is a pull-up. They have given, the very same day, there is an Indulge supplement. Many of you might have seen that Indulge supplement. See, this is, I kind of, my understanding is, anything that comes from the spiritual thing, immediately, because of the conditioned understanding that in the healing, only the established method, why can't we explore a newer dimension of healing? While in that news report they mentioned, in New York or some Yale University, they already have opened a spiritual healing division and they are exploring. See, science is about exploration and trying to understand. If we fail, we fail. We openly accept. But until we fail, we still have a chance. So hence, but in that pull-out, they kind of in the name of fashion, in the name of entertainment, in the name of style, they are pushing the Western design of the cloth, etc. While anything that comes from the indigenous approach of healing, immediately there is a dissenting comment that is added to here. That's why there is a famous series of video that is going on, the Sahibs who never left. The Sahibs means the British this thing. So they have entered into our system, or especially in the media. Media is basically trained to look westward only, not from an indigenous perspective. Today morning I was reading this. So this gives the basis that Atma Jnanam is, so Atma Jnanam has again various layers that we have seen, and it is also not said that in one go it will heal you. It is also said that it is Bhuya, Bhuya, repeated and the slow systematic pursuit only will go. So and Rachu Avabodha, that is not a snake but it is only a rope that doesn't descend, that understanding doesn't come about easily. Someone should assist. If I am to take a decision, just think about this, if I am to take a decision whether it is a snake or a goat, most probably what decision I will come about? Fear or running away. I will, at my level, if I have to decide, going to take a risk whether or not going closer to it and switching on the light, the light switch is there, the snake is there, on my own I will not try out anything, I will run away. But someone else has to come and assist. So that is also important. If you think about this shloka in a deeper way, so many an assisted self-discovery. Spirituality is nothing but, so we can derive a definition of spirituality also from this, if possible. We can think and discuss. Maybe in other sections of Yoga Vasishtha this is elaborated. Spirituality is self-discovery. It may be an assisted self-discovery because Bhuya, Loka Parikshana, for Parikshana, so many people should come together. Examination Madam is there, so how many people are there required to conduct an examination? It is a great, it is an Utsava in itself. So many people, Parikshana, examination requires the assistance and presence and coordination and cooperation of so many. So in Atma Jnanam also, Parikshana has to be done. So many assisting factors. So all that is captured in this sutra-like shloka. So spirituality in healing, especially healing of the diseases of the mind which are potent. So the methodology and approach is given here. So this is a worth reflecting upon. Layers and layers of meanings are there. One can think about it. Then see, and there is another shloka in Yoga Vasishtha. It says, Vasana Samparityage Yadi Yatnam Karoshyaram Tatte Shithiratam Yanti Sarvadhi Dadhagaha Kshanat. So all that you have to do is put in the effort to overcome the Vasanas. Vasana Samparityage Yatnam Karoshi Chetalam Shithiratam Yanti. The Adhis and Vyadhis will be loosened and weakened if you overcome the Vasanas. I gave the example of a person being operated upon, that chit jada granchi. So it is about vasana. That today I was again doing one yoga sutra, explaining another yoga sutra, where we have beautiful sutra which again beautifully fits in to this explanation. Bahi akal pita vritti mahavideha tataha prakasha varadakshaya. Third chapter, 41-42 sutra. This sutra can also be connected here. Many of you might have practiced this Yoga Nidra of Satyananda, Swami Satyananda, Narayananda, they teach that. In that, they don't give this terminology, but the terminology is in the Yoga Sutra. What they say is they relax all the limbs, and then at a particular stage they will say, you visualize that you are outside this body, and then you are observing this. What is the outcome of that? You just feel that you are, we feel deeply entrenched or connected with this system. So we may not be able to look at this body objectively as it is. So we always feel if anything, something happened here, we are worried about it immediately. Some crack or some injury or some cut happens, we are immediately worried about it. Objectively, some amount of objectivity is achieved by such practices. So, akal videha, that's a videha practice. Videha means body, videha, disembodied. here is yourself as not being connected to the body. So that you can see one thing happens is some vairagya will come, some element of detachment will come to this system, so that when the detachment is there, too much of kleshas will not be there. See, when we are very deeply attached to our system, we are extremely worried. That worry can be avoided if some amount of videha training is given. See, body is one layer of yourself. How can we bring about by motion? This videha dimension can be given. By that, the sutra itself says the benefit of prakasha, avarana, kshaya. Prakasha means clarity, light. Avarana means that which covers. Kshaya means deterioration. All the clouds, your clarity will come down if you practice that videha. Videha practice. So in that sense, all these practices, that is Atmajnana. Atmajnana is understanding that you are not limited only to the body. So to that, Videha Vritti is a supplement. So your mind is different, your body is different. That is, see, third chapter is brush aside as only focus on walking on the sky, walking on the water. But these insights are there. So you can, beautifully integrate such practices as a supplement. Is this a spiritual practice? Again, a module can be re-look into the third chapter to look for ideas and insights which will contribute to spirituality in healing. So can that be a dimension? So hence, and one more thing here is, spirituality is also defined here. What is spirituality? It is not about faith in God. In this shloka, what comes through this is, it is not about faith in God. In this, of course, we are all astikas, have great sraddha. But here, what we see in this shloka is that it is about discovery of yourself. That is spirituality here. And the approach is also our bodha. So the tool, so we can spend a lot of time on this sutra, in this shloka itself. So Atmajnana comes by avabodha. Atmajnana can come about only by understanding. Avabodha, understanding. And then how should that understanding be? Bhuya doesn't come by one time. It has to be done again and again and again. So these are the beautiful insights. This can be a central guiding principle for slowly integrating spirituality into healing. So much of thought on this. I will stop at this. One can expand or elaborate on this, this thing.
Sir, Manasika Vyadhi in Ayurveda is factored through this sutra. Dhi, Dhairya and Atmadhi Vignanam Manovabhavjanam Paramparam. This is the sutra. How to tackle?
Which
this is from Ashtanga. I am telling you. Sharirajanam Doshanam Krameda Paramausharam Vastir Virego Vamanam Tatha Thailam Pritam Padutu. That is Sharirajanam. How to tackle it? Dhi, Dhairya and Atmadhi Vignanam Manovabhavjanam Paramparam. That means everything whatever is told there,
yes,
is made as a sutra.
Both of these are connected. And that is Sara. So that is Ashtanga beautifully fits in.
100% fits, sir.
Now we go to the next shloka. And in this shloka, see, we are not worried about the sara. Anyhow, it is going to be a companion with us for the life. Let us only manage the samanya. No, that should not be the approach. That is clarified through this shloka. First of all, have a deep focus on the saravyati. Samanya, anyhow you can manage. Samanya, anyhow it can be managed by various approaches. Always be oriented towards that saravyati. That's why, see, this is again deeply connected to the purushartha. Dharma, artha, kama, moksha. Among this, what is parama purushartha? Moksha is the parama purushartha. So the ultimate purushartha, that is moksha, you have to pursue. Not only for attaining liberation, the spiritual goal, but also to keep you in a state of good health and well-being. So it has implications on health also, that Parama Purushartha. the deeper connections that it brings up.
आदित्य आदि विलासाना आदि
parties are there and their vilasa is there. They play on us, the human system, vilasa, they play. In the play of the adhis and vilasa, so how beautiful way of looking at it. It is that, so we are the stage in which adhis and vyadhis come and play. So in an easy way it has been taken. So quite natural for us to experience all these adhis and vyadhis. Among the exuberance, vilasa actually, if you want to put the right English word, among the exuberance of adhis and vyadhis, Sara adhi samshayaha. So, very focused attempt to reduce. Adhi samshayaha means a complete overcoming of Sara, of the potent dimension. Among the adhis and vyadhis, among the interplay or the exuberance of adhis and vyadhis, where should one focus? One should focus on dismantling, overcoming adhi samshaya, to remove sara, the potent illness. So, by just looking at the potent nature of it, we should not give up, we should give more effort on overcoming the sara vyadhi and sara adhis. Okay? Why? If you focus on the sara, adhis and vyadhis, then what happens? Sarvesham mulaha. Sarvesham. Of all the problems that you have with related to adhi and vyadhi, sarvesham adhinam vyadhinam mulaha. Mula is the root. Ha means hanti nashaya. See, if you focus on the sara sankshaya, if you focus on removing the sara, then what happens is all other problems are, their roots are removed. Mulaha is a beautiful expression. Mulaha. This mulaha expression is also found in Kautilya Arthashastra. Mulaha means that in Kautilya Arthashastra, who is a mulaha means a person who has inherited a lot of wealth from his father and grandfather. He himself does not do any work. And whatever he has inherited, he is simply eating and just enjoying. See, without creating any further revenue, to simply empty the inherited wealth, what is your mula? The wealth that you already have, you should protect it. Over that, you should put in your work and earn some money, so that your mula is always protected, and in times of contingency, you use it. But if you just live upon the wealth that is inherited, such a person is condemned by Kautilya as mulaha. So that is a different connotation. That's the beauty of Sanskrit. Here, will a tree survive if its root is cut asunder? No. So similarly, if you focus on the sara, adhis and vyadhis, it is as cutting the roots of the tree. Then all the manifestations in the form of flowers, fruits, etc. will not be there. All the problems created by the adhis and vyadhis will not be there. If you cut the mula, if you focus on the sara dimension of it and overcome. A beautiful example that is given is Pravrin Nadi. Pravrin Nadi. Nadi, you know. Pravrit Nadi. Pravrit Nadi. Pravrit means a rainy seasonal river. The river of a rainy season. How will it be?
Swollen
river. Swollen river is Pravrit Nadi. Beautiful expression. A swollen river, what will it do? Tata Virudha. Virudha refers to trees. The trees which are on the banks of a swollen river, what will happen? Mulaha. From the root it will uproot. Even though it is a very big to overgrown tree, if it is on the banks of a swollen river, from the root it will be taken away. So, don't worry about the size of the tree. If the river is swollen, it will carry away. Similarly, if the river So probably the spiritual dimension of healing is fundamental. About it only comes the other dimensions of healing according to your process. So that is the foundation upon which if you take care of the root, the shoots and flowers and other things, it will dry out, it will anyhow fall. So hence, this we can see that a beautiful contrast or a core two shlokas have been given to describe the dimension of approaching adis and yadis, especially the sara dimension, potent. So they were never afraid of taking on the difficult. Samanya they should be dismissed, but the sara also is not to be dismissed. That also needs to be addressed. That has been addressed in these two shlokas. We will chant this shloka, beautiful shloka once, and then complete.